Hey everyone, I'm Daniel from LAND Software. In this video, I'll show you how to construct and control a new terrain in relation with a couple of existing objects in ARCHICAD using LAND4. So in the 3D view, we can visualize that we have a building, which I constructed using ARCHICAD objects, and a ramp for which I used LAND4 objects and tools. Find the link to the video in the description below. Back to plan view, I will first create the existing terrain using the spot levels, and we can also visualize it in the 3D view. Here we can see that the terrain doesn't follow neither the ramp or the building. I can now delete the existing terrain and start constructing the new one. Using the selection palette, I can make selections based on a category, so my spot levels for the existing are placed in LAND4 existing, and I can make a selection. If I go back to the palette, we can also make a selection for the ramp category where I placed the spot levels and the ridge lines. So once my objects are selected, I can now close the palette and use the copy to category function to copy these objects into LAND4 new. Once the objects are copied, if I zoom in, we can now see that the spot levels are basically overlapped and they are the same objects just placed in two different categories, also having a different appearance. So now, if I go into the layers management and hide the existing layers where I place the existing spot levels, I will have basically a copy of the same spot levels in the LAND4 new category. And I'll work with these spot levels from now on. I will also need to add the objects within the ramp category. So if I select once more the spot levels in the ramp and the ridge lines, I can now copy them into the LAND4 new because I would like to use these features in creating the new terrain. So I'm basically preparing all the objects in LAND4 new. When creating the surface again, we can see now that the features in the ramp, the spot levels and the ridge lines are also selected. So now if I zoom in, we can see that these are the spot levels shown or representing the existing terrain, the old terrain. Therefore, are interfering with the new terrain. So I will have to select them and delete them. And I will select the spot levels which are within the ramp area or surrounding the ramp, because that's where I want to control the new terrain. And once I deleted these spot levels, I can maybe I can delete a few around the ramp too. And now I can create again the terrain. Now we can already see on the level lines that they are not overlapped anymore. In the 3D view, we can now see that the terrain, it follows the ramp. Because of the ridge lines representing the ramp, they are now in the right category. I can create also a hole in the surface. So I simply select the fill tool and using the magic wand, I can create a hole in the new terrain. So as you can see now, the new terrain follows and shows the ramp. Now that I'm done working with the ridge lines and the spot levels from the ramp, I can delete the surface and start working with the ridge line around the building. So I just need to draw a simple polyline following the building's geometry, and I can select it, and as we can see now, we have just a 2D polyline. What I need to do is basically add spot levels along and connect these spot levels to the line in some specific locations I want to have control over the line. I can use some of the existing spot levels to interpolate new ones, so I want to have a fall from the ramp here of 4%. Here I can add maybe, I can manually add a spot level with 10 centimeters lower than the ramp. And I can have the same maybe height around here until the middle. On this corner, I could use maybe a 2-point interpolation to place a spot level in the corner. And the spot levels, which are very close to the building, I can just delete them. Maybe I would like to have another fall in this area, so I can use another interpolation, maybe 3% this time, and place a spot level here in the middle. Now that I have all the spot levels placed, I can create the ridge line out of the polyline. So I just select it, and now I need to add each of the spot levels to the line. Once I'm done, I press the green mark, and now my polyline becomes a 3D line. We can see it in the 3D view, and we can see that it follows the building, and it's basically meeting the spot levels we added to the line. Here on this side, we have a fall on each side of the entrance. And in the back of the building, the line follows the spot levels we have added. So now using this ridge line, we will be able to control the land surface to follow precisely. I can always add new spot levels to a ridge line. So I will add another one on this side of the entrance to with a fall of 3%. And add it to the line. And now back to 3D, we can see the ridge line has adapted. This way I can make sure I have a fall on each side of the entrance. Now that I have my ridge line done, I can create again the new surface. I can create again the holes in the fill for both the ramp and the house. Back to 3D, we can now see the new terrain. So this is just a simple way on how to control your terrain using ridge lines or 3D lines. I can also control the terrain around the house by using another ridge line with a buffer of a certain distance. And in this way, I can make sure there is a fall from the building towards the terrain. So back to plan view, I can delete the new surface again. And I will use the initial ridge line of the building to copy paste it. Now I'm asked by LAND4 if I want to copy also the spot levels contained by it or just the line. And I don't want the spot levels. So I will select the polyline and I will use offset to all ridges function. And I'll offset it for maybe 1 meter. So now I have another polyline with a buffer of 1 meter. I can select it and then trim it to the ramp on each side. And now I can delete the line, the middle line, because I don't want to interfere with the terrain around the ramp, only around the house. Now I can use maybe an interpolation with a fall of 3% for each corner. Here, where the ramp meets the ridge line, I will use the gravity tool to place a spot level at the height of the ramp. So it'll basically the value will be read from the ramp. In this way, the ridge line will meet the ramp precisely at that height. Now I'll do the same on the other side. I will add one more spot level here. And now I'm ready to transform the polyline into a ridge line by adding the spot levels I just placed to the line. I'm now done creating the second ridge line, and we can now see it in the 3D view already. So we have basically a parallel ridge line which has a fall of 3% along, and it meets the ramp at the same height. You can always change the color of the ridge line in the 3D view. So I need to select it, and then I can access the ridge line settings. Here I am now using the model view option, so I can uncheck and then change the ridge line pen for the 3D view. So if I pick another color and press OK, now the ridge line will be represented by that color. This way could help you to distinguish different ridge lines you're using within your project. I will create the new terrain again, and this time also the second ridge line will be included in the modeling. So in this way we can make sure we have a fall from the building towards the terrain with a certain percentage. Once we are done constructing the land surface, I can always transform it into a mesh. So I just need to select the fill and press on the Create Mesh from a Land Surface button. As you can see now, the mesh was generated quick, and I can drag it and maybe move it on the side here. And in the 3D view, we can visualize and compare the mesh with a land surface. So this was a short video on how to construct and control a new terrain based on the existing terrain in relation with a couple of objects in ARCHICAD. For more videos, visit our YouTube channel or land4cad.com.